Good morning. It's good to see everybody out there. I can barely see the boat far away, but good morning to you. Well, have a wonderful day in the Lord. We're just getting set up, waiting on Sammy. I think Sammy's still coming. And we're going to have a great time in the Lord. So just pray, praying for the service. Amen. Pray for the ones that are still have the virus that needs healing touches today, miracles in the Lord. And pray for our country to recover. Good morning. And there's many needs today that's out and abroad, and children and that are in need of food, and we want to be praying that God will make a way for them just as well. Amen. And let me see here. I saw somebody, but I couldn't help. Cindy, good to see you. Looks like James is there. My, looks like we have Jesse Pennington. It's good to see you all this morning. Hope I got those names right. And we're working on hopefully having an awesome service. Amen. And I'm gonna find out where Sammy's at. So we're just waiting for a few minutes, and hopefully I'm gonna get my tablet up, which I can better get a better view of Facebook. And we're going to get that done, the Lord's will. I want to try to upgrade so we can have some more wonderful services. Might even have a few little special services in between that. Today, we're going to go into the Word of God here a little bit shortly when the service starts and everything gets going good. And we're going to talk about something that God had given me this week, and it's about why did Satan want heaven? Why did Satan want heaven? We're going to be in Isaiah, so chapter 14 and 12. So you get your Bibles ready. We're not going to preach right now. And we're going to start out in that area, but God is going to enlighten the new way of our life today. And why did Satan want heaven? Well, we know why, but we're not going to get into that. Amen? So, all right. God bless you guys. Love you. Glad you're coming on. I hope we get more and more each time. It gets better and better. More services we're going to have. We might even start doing interviews of singers and things like that. I've been working on maybe a Saturday weekend having that. So bear with us. Lord's will. You never know what God can probably do.
Hey, Paul.
Yes.
Sammy's here.
Oh, wonderful. Come on down. Hey, bring his bottle of water down, please. Oh, never mind. So Sammy's coming right now, and so we're going to go ahead.
And I'm going to give you a song. Chapter 16, verse 25.
We'll do a little praise and worship.
It says, "And at midnight." Everybody say, "And at midnight." And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them.
Yes.
Is your praise loud enough for God to hear you tonight? Did you come to bring something to God tonight? Did you come to bring something to God tonight? you come to bring something to God tonight? Verse 26, and it says, suddenly, there was a great earthquake, so that the foundation of the prison were shaken.
Come on.
And immediately, say immediately.
Immediately.
What does immediately mean? That means right now. That means not next week. That means not two days from
right now.
That means right now. Immediately.
Right now.
I need it immediately.
Right now.
You need it immediately. I need it immediately.
Amen.
Because immediately all the doors were open. And everyone's bands were loosed. That means that your praise can shake the foundation of this room. And it can loose somebody standing next to you. I don't know about you, but I know about me. I have some bands, some things that I need the foundation to shake off of my life. So I'm going to praise him enough that when I shake the foundation with my praise,
looks like you're growing another kid.
Then my praise is going to shake and loose the bands off of you. So if you have something that you need moved in your life tonight, come on. Do you have something you need moved in your life tonight? I want you to do something that we just did upstairs. I want you to give God the loudest praise so that a suddenly and an immediately can happen in this room tonight. The loudest pray that you can, that lets him know that you want him to come right now in this room.
Tonight is the night.
Get you fixed. How about now?
Yeah. I see me.
You see me? You want me to get this out of the way?
Yeah.
Always good to see you, Brother Sammy.
Good to see you, brother.
Amen. Brother Sammy is an excellent singer. You already know this, but some of her Facebook fans don't know. Amen. But Sammy's an awesome singer. He's been he's always been on my side when I need somebody to come and sing for God. And you told me, you said, always come, I'm singing for God. And I said, amen. Amen. I didn't ask you to come sing for me. I asked you to come sing for God. Amen.
That's right.
And you know, God has really blessed you, Brother Sammy,
down
through the years. And I want to get into a big interview, but we're going to start some of this interviewing pretty soon. Maybe I want to sit down with you. We're going to share how you started your history and things like that, which I think they would like that just as well. Maybe on a Saturday we'll get that chance and sit down. And we'll get many others maybe to come in and sit down and tell their story. What do you think?
Sounds good to me.
Be awesome. So we're looking forward to that just as well. So we got about 2 or 3 minutes, but we can go ahead and start, I guess, can't we?
I reckon.
And praise the Lord. Amen. And as you come on, it's not too late to never come on. Amen. It doesn't matter if he sings 1 or 20. But you just get in there and you give God praise this morning and lift him up. Amen.
Amen.
And so, by that token, it's just an honor to have you, so I would like for you to open up in prayer. Go ahead, brother.
Dear precious Heavenly Father, Lord God, we come to you in the precious name of Jesus. We praise you and we thank you, Lord God, for another chance to gather together today in your name, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, that you have your way in this service today, Lord God. As Brother Carl brings the word, Lord God,
yes.
And as you minister through the both of us today, Lord God, let somebody be touched, let a soul be saved in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. All right, Brother Sammy, you got it. It's mine, the Lord.
He's under my feet. He's under my feet.
feet. Amen. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. Satan is under my feet. Well, I went to the enemy's camp and I took back what he stole from me. Well, I took back what he stole from me. You see, I took back what he stole from me. Well, I went to the enemy's camp and I took back what he stole from me. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. Keep him under your feet where he belongs. Amen.
Amen.
Don't keep him behind you because he can sneak up on you if you're behind you.
Amen.
But keep him under the feet where he belongs. Amen.
Yes, praise God.
Amen.
Amen. Mind the Lord this morning.
True that you are thinking of me.
Amen.
I Now, I'm going to, see how I can't really stay.
That's all right.
I got to get to my next service here.
Tell them what's going on up there. You want to sing one more for your leg?
I'm going to sing two more.
Okay. Tell them what's going on.
Today is our first service back in the building. They've been having parking lot services. Really, it's my first service back, period, since all this stuff started. Because since all this stuff started, they've been mandating me to work every single Sunday until today. So,
what church is that?
It's the old Cremains Chapel building.
Amen.
Out at 7791 9 Mile Road. And Right Fork 9 Mile Road, I think it is.
Amen.
No, Left Fork, sorry.
That's right.
Left Fork 9 Mile Road. And we start at noon, so if any of you out that way want to go, then you all go on right ahead. We'd love to have you. But we do ask that you practice social distancing. If you ride in the same vehicle.
Amen.
Try to sit together so that you can get out the door and leave together. Amen. But we're going to have a good time in the Lord there today, just like you're having a good time in the Lord
Amen.
Here. But those that may be going through something, maybe you felt like you're just not worth nothing, okay? Maybe you felt like what you're doing is in vain. Well, maybe you feel like that, well, maybe you're out there and maybe you feel like killing yourself because of things that have happened. Listen to the words of this song. It says, fear is a liar.
Amen. Bless you, Jesus.
Told you you're not good enough, when he told you you're not right, when he told you you're not strong enough to put up a good fight, when he told you you're not worthy, when he told you you're not loved, when he told you you're not beautiful, you'll never be enough. Take your breath, stop you in your steps. Now fear, he is a liar.
Amen.
He will rob your rest, steal your happiness, cast your fear in the fire. Fire. I'm going to leave you with this old song right here. I'm kind of old anyway. It says, thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me.
Amen.
He has blessed us all throughout the years. Amen. Brother Carl, if you know this song, sing with me.
Okay.
Facebook page really at any time today, because it's going on up until I think about 12:30 tonight, but I will be on there at 9 o'clock this evening, Eastern time, 8 p.m. Central time, and I will be going live from there on that page and sharing the gospel there.
Tell them about that. What is that? I was going to ask you that.
That is a stay-at-home concert series.
Okay.
That couple out of Hamilton, Ohio has put together that last weekend, this weekend, and they're going to do one next weekend as well. I'm not sure exactly what day and what time I'm going to be next weekend. We haven't got all that sorted out yet. But singers from all across the nation, and I'm even going to be posting my pastor's preaching video on there a little bit later. I can't go live with that because I don't get cell service out there. But
bless him, Lord.
Anyway, singers from all across the country. To this morning, it started at 8 a.m. It's going to go till about 12:30 tonight. If you're not doing anything at any point today, you want to be blessed, get on there and listen to some good singing.
Amen.
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 Well, God bless y'all.
Hey, love you, Brother Samuel. Thank you for coming by. Amen.
Thank you.
And I hope that we're going to get some more singers just as well. Amen. Did y'all enjoy that this morning? If you do, get some likes up to that. Amen. God is good, ain't he?
Amen.
Hey, that's better than me getting up here and howling a little bit. But you know what? I howl for the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And I ain't going to put myself that far down. I can't sing a little, you know. Sammy, I just love him tremendously. And I'm just so glad to have you. I really think when you come down to our little basement today, amen?
Amen.
Where the Lord is where we can come in the name of the Lord, amen?
I come anywhere and share the Lord.
I know you do, and you proved that again, over and over, amen?
Amen.
We love you, Brother Sammy.
God bless you all.
God bless you. Thank you. And again, just so great to have you guys. And we had a few just a minute ago come down and... You know, I got a few seats here. We can always have church, amen. And I hope you don't run away, because I want to entitle this message this morning. It's called "The Devil Wanted Heaven." Now, you come on, I want you to think about that this morning. The devil, why did the devil want heaven? And I thought about that in our lives. And why does Satan had such a want to get heaven, just take over it. So hopefully we're going to rightly break down the word to you today. And as you pray for me, but before we do that, we're going to, I just want to say something here. We had this picture, this cross back here. And this has been with me since 2000, okay? And I want to tell you something. It makes me cry. I have three grandchildren that I don't get to see, that I love very much. I want to see them so much in my heart. And before they left, and I'm not going to try to get too far down and get my heart over them. Because God's got this situation. God's going to make a way. Amen? So you'd be praying for that. And God opens the door and lets us see those children. But this cross... Jenna is the middle-aged child, and she was probably about 6 years old. And this, I believe, happened at the Prince of Peace Free Will Baptist Church. They had a time where they could color things and make things, and she made me a cross. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. This is a child-made painting. And I saw it when I was thinking about, since I don't have appointments to go out and preach the gospel and at this moment in time, and I thought, well, what can I do? And the Lord said, you can still have church. And I thought, you're right, because you're with me. And I thought, amen. And so when I come to my basement, God said, right there's your church. You can have church like Joyce Myers. She had church in her basement, and it grew and grew and grew. And you see how big that ministry is today. But saying that in perspective, my grandbaby made this, and I saw it sitting on the shelf down here in the basement. And when I was putting the church together, it struck my heart. I said, you know what? She made that for a reason. She knew I was going to need this in the future. And here it is, hanging up behind me. And I count that as a privilege and an honor, which I'll share with her in the future. And hopefully real soon, be able to see her, tell her, and share the things of our life. And she made that picture. Ain't that beautiful? She made a cross, and she put the sun behind it. Oh, man, ain't the Father good? He's always behind the sun, amen? His son was died upon the cross of Calvary for your sins, that we may go free. Amen? I want you to think about that cross this morning. And he died on the cross. He bled and he died. So me and you would never have to burn in hell, that our names be written in the Lamb's Book of Life. We'll live in heaven one day. And she put the sun behind it. And I thought about the Father being so bright behind the sun. And Jesus on the cross, and his Father is behind him because he supports him. Amen. And it's just a blessing. Amen. So it's a blessing to have you all this morning out there. And it seems like it gets better and better each time. So we want to go ahead and get into the Word, and I'm going to go ahead and say a little prayer before we begin. And hopefully that this will concede your heart, help you to do more for the Lord. Amen. All right, Father, we thank you for another opportunity as we come to you. Humbles, we know how to thank you for this beautiful day and the people that's got on Facebook with us and the special singer today, Lord, that you sent, Brother Sammy. And Lord, as he lifted you up high, we're thankful for that this morning. Now, we ask, Lord, rightly that you break the Word down this morning into our hearts, into our homes. Lord, that we may not sin against you, Father. Lord, that we may grow stronger and get a fire burning deeper and get the understanding deeper, more that we can have more hunger for you to hear your Word, more hunger, Lord, to hear your praises come through songs and testimonies. God, and we're just thankful today to have this opportunity again. We love you, Lord, and you speak as we stand here today. Use this mouthpiece. In Jesus' name, and the church said, amen. All right, well, this morning, if you got your Bibles, I want you to go to Isaiah chapter 14 and verse 12, and we're gonna rightly break down the Word of God this morning. And I'm going to give you a few minutes. Isaiah chapter 14 and verse 12. Chapter 14 and verse 12. And you go ahead and get there. And I'll give you just a minute. And I've been thinking about, why did Satan want to take over heaven? More than wanted to. He wanted to be God. He wanted to be God. Uh-huh. So, but we're gonna break this down today. Why was the cause? Why he has such a thirst for heaven, which he can't have now, which we know that, but why did he? So when you get there, we'll go ahead and say amen. Even if I don't hear you, God hears you. Amen. Okay, Isaiah 14, verse 12, and it says in the readings, how art thou fallen? It says, how thou have fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, which is another word of Satan. His name was Lucifer, an angel. And it said, how art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, the son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground, which does weaken the nation? Okay, for thou hast said in thy heart, I will descend. This is what he said. Satan said, he said, I will descend into the heavens, and I will exalt my throne above the stars of God, and I will also set up on the mount of the congregation in the sight of the north, verse 14, and I will descend above the highest of the clouds, and I will make light into the most high. You think about that. I want you to think about what he's saying this morning. Why did Satan begin to want this morning? I've got to move my chair. I'm saying I've got to get me a podium. If I'm going to preach the gospel, I got to stand up. Amen. I feel like I get hindered, but I'm not going to let hindrance bother me. Amen. And I want you to understand this morning, why did Satan want heaven for? Why was so important that he thought heaven was something important to him? And I begin to think, when God left him in charge, he didn't mean to say, you're all boss. Amen. He didn't mean to tell him because he was in charge of heaven up there. He just wanted to be greedy in his life. Amen. I want you to understand something this morning. There's some great things in heaven. Heaven is a wonderful place. And it said in Revelation in 21 and 18, it said this. It said that the walls are, the gates are jasper and the walls of pearl. And the streets are of gold. You can read back in Revelation and see that. I want to tell you something. Maybe it was because of the walls of jasper and the streets of the gates of pearls. And I mean 12 gates to the city. Hallelujah. Amen. And when he got and he realized, I can see around heaven and I know what I see. I see the streets of gold. I see the walls of jasper. Oh my, it looks so good. And then I begin to see. I see over when the gates of pearl, and it looks so good. He said, oh my, I begin to wonder what he was thinking. But I can tell you this, his eyes got the splendors of the beauty and the holiness of God. And he realized this is a holy place that they're standing in, because heaven is not corrupt, and there ain't no corrupt thing going to enter into the heavens. And I begin to think about that old heavenly home that God had built with me, without man's hands. He said that no man has entered in. And he said that the only way they'll enter in is through the blood of Christ this morning. Now, I begin to think about these things in our life. I begin to think about what he was saying about the heavens, how beautiful it was. Maybe if it wasn't for the walls of jasper and the gates of pearl and the streets of gold. Maybe it was the stream of life, the water flows freely, it's crystal clear from the throne. How about that? Maybe it was the green grass that is beautiful there. Amen. Maybe this morning, maybe it was all that. Maybe it was because the angels was singing into the heavens as it mellowed out and everybody began to hush because it's perfect there. Amen. Hey, maybe it's because he knew his Father was there up on the throne and he realized in life. I want you to understand something this morning. Why did Satan want it so bad? Well, let me tell you this morning, I think this verse kind of entwines in our life. And he said, "Thou that hath fallen from the heavens, O Lucifer, the son of the morning, that hast cast it down to the ground. You have weakened the nation. You have weakened the nation because you corrupted yourself. And now, therefore, no corrupt thing will enter into the kingdom of God." And God put him out. Do you realize there was a war in heaven? Do you realize that? There was a war in heaven, and it was Satan, and they battled, and the angels battled, because they realized, you're not coming in, Satan, you're not destroying, you're not taking away, you're not going to do this. We will fight you every step of the way, because this is God's kingdom, not your kingdom this morning. I began to think about that thing, so when he battled so hard, and he realized he'd done lost, and then the Lord casted him out into the ground. And when he did, he weakened our nation. Do you realize this morning Satan is weakening this nation? Huh? Do you realize that Satan is running the earth? He runs it? God has made the earth. Yes, in Genesis, it sure told us about in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Amen. Amen. Not Satan, God. Amen. God created everything. He created man. He created woman. He created animals. God made it. He said that it was all good. And he said on the seventh day he rested, didn't he? And then when he made Adam and Eve, I thought about that. When he made Adam and Eve, you could read back in Genesis later. And I began to think about back there in Genesis. And as he had Adam and Eve, and when he was in the Garden of Eden, and they was in that Garden of Eden, and I'm just sitting there in my mind beginning to ponder about that, and the serpent was in the presence. Do you realize when God told Adam and Eve and them not Eve to not eat of the forbidden fruit that was on the tree that was there? I began to think about what was going on. God created it all; it was beautiful. It had to be, and it still is. It still is. Our nation is not done. God is still on the throne. God is still saving. And we can still clean our nation up through the blood of Christ. Amen. That's the only thing can straighten all this mess up, even the virus. God is the way maker, the healer this morning in Jesus' name. God is the cleanser. Amen. Woo! Glory be to God. God is the cleanser this morning. I begin to think about all of that, and when Eve began to eat of the forbidden fruit, and when she took of that, as Satan said, that your eyes will be opened up, and you'll know from good and evil. I just know right there what was said. and it began to stir my heart of what happened. And she got tricked by the devil, and he began to tell her lies so that her eyes would be opened. And Adam and Eve began to realize that they didn't have clothes, and he ran and hid and put on fig leaves to hide their nakedness. I began to think about that. When God made the city, our country, and I mean our world, and he made it, he meant to be holy, pure, clean, good. He wanted to be like heavenly, like, and pure, no bad thoughts. And oh my goodness, this world is so polluted right now with bad thoughts. Pornography is really, really bad out there, really bad. And people don't care to flaunt it. Some of them will flaunt it right out. You'll see it. If you're standing around, some people have it right on their phones. It's sad. Sad, sad that Satan is lying to them this morning. He takes them away for the few moments of life. Do you realize that our life was like a vapor in James 4? Said our life was like a vapor. We're here today. We're going tomorrow. We're going to pass away. We're going to move on. One day I'm going to go home to be with the Lord. And can you say the same this morning? Can you say that? And he said this, when Satan had been casted out, when God came down, Jesus came down to him, he told Satan, on the ground and on your belly you shall crawl. I began to think about that serpent. And the woman now had to bear the pain of her life. And I began to think about the more motive things that started occurring. Then I believe we started really, sin started stirring, and we realized then we're going to start dying from that point on. Amen. And so it said this, and then how then if Lucifer the son of the morning, how art thou cast into the ground and a weak in the nation? For thou hast said in thy heart, I will descend into heavens. Why did he want to stand up? Because he wants to get above God. Amen. And then he said this, I would descend above the heavens and the stars of God upon the mount of the congregation on the north. And I would descend above the heights of the cloud, and I will be like the Most High. Ain't that what Satan's trying to do again right now? He's trying to be the Most High down here when he's already defeated. Do you realize he's defeated? He's defeated. God, when he was on the cross and when he died, and on, he went to hell and he went down and he took the keys right out of Satan's hands. Amen. He took the keys out and he bounded him. Hey, glory be to God. Ain't you thankful for that this morning? That's where Satan's at this morning. But his spirit does roam and he tries to tear and he tries to take away. Do you realize for the wages of the sin is death, not just on you, but your whole entire family? This morning, let me tell you, you read back there in Exodus, and you read back in Deuteronomy, and you read back in Leviticus, you read back, and you're going to say that everything that they did wrong, that there was a consequence to their whole entire family this morning. It's time to clean your house, amen. It's time to get that junk out of your house. I mean, clean it in the name of Jesus. First, you got to get your heart right with God, amen. First, you got to embody man and wash and let him wash you with his blood this morning. Hallelujah. Be purged in the blood this morning. Get your name written down in the Lamb's Book of Life. Hey, Christian, if your house ain't so right, it better be right, because Jesus is coming. Amen. Jesus is coming this morning. Make your house right. Throw out the bad things. Get it out. Shut the door and say, for me and my house, Isaiah, is the scripture this morning. It said, for me and my house, I will serve the Lord. So that means in this house here, and the house that I live in here, thank God it's just a temporary stay. And God owns it all. Amen. He owns everything this morning. And I begin to think about all these things, your house being garnished, swept, because we're getting closer to the door. Do you realize that this morning? And Satan keeps rising his ugly head, and he steals our kids. Oh my gosh, what heartbreak we're having. Oh my gosh, he lies to them. And he tells them the things that you see in the world, go ahead and partake, and it'll be okay. And we see kids out here that are on having problems of being high. Oh my heart breaks at 3 o'clock in the morning. I go to work and I look over and I see this person in the grass with their shirt off, and they're just laying there. They need help. And the only thing that can help them is the Lord. And I realize that our police and our firemen and all that, they do their best to try to help them. But some people won't take the help. It's sad this morning. But you know what? I just want to let you know this morning that Satan had a better vision of heaven that time. He realized, he said, I will be, and I'm going to get down to this because I'm going to close off in verse 13. And he said, chapter 14, verse 13, for thou hast said in thy heart, I will descend into heaven. That's what he wanted to do. And he said, I will exalt the throne above the stars of God. He said, I'll get above him, man. I'll just go ahead and get on top. That's what Satan was trying to do. Do you realize it's all about power? Satan's always wanting power. Am I right? Amen. I'll see amen, amen, amen. You can see amen. You know it's about power. And he knows if he gets to the top and he gets into heaven and he takes over, then God and his son Jesus has no more authority. You see what I'm saying to you? He realized that if he makes it up there, then he will be the king. Then he will be over the nations. Then he will rule it the way he wants. And I can already tell you from what I'm already saw now in this lifetime, I don't want Satan ruling nothing. Amen. Not nothing. Because he's done nothing but steal, kill, and destroy. That's all he's done. It's all he's took away. And it makes me angry to know that Satan wants to destroy our whole entire family this morning. He wants to destroy us. And I tell you, it's sad. And then he said in verse 14, I will descend above the heights of the clouds and will be like in the Most High. When I get up, that's why he said, when I get there. But let me tell you something this morning. Woo! Well, glory. Hey! Satan is defeated this morning. Amen. Satan is defeated this morning. Get the understanding. And Satan, you know it. You're defeated. You lost a long time ago when Jesus casted him out of the heavens. And God took over the throne even more, and he put his house in order. And now heaven is repaired with the unseen hand this morning. Amen. A holy, pure city this morning that the nation or that sin can never enter in. Amen. Boy, I tell you, ain't that good to know that one day my brother and my sister in Christ, that one day we're going to go to heaven and no more Satan tempting me and you. No more Satan lying to our kids that don't go to church. Amen. No more lying. There won't be no more grace. No more heartache. No more pain. No more sorrow. No more politics. Amen. Woo! Glory be to God. Because it's all over with. Do you realize that? It's all over with. We're going to go home to be with Jesus one day. To live for eternity with God. Think about what I'm saying. Don't you want to live eternity with God this morning? Don't you? I hope you do this morning. I hope you're saying yes in your heart. Now, I don't want to live the life that I'm living now. And yes, I want to make a change. But the life that I've got way into, I don't think God loves me. Let me tell you something this morning. God loves all, A-L-L, all sinners this morning. I was a sinner, unrighteous, undone, without God, and I was in a lot of trouble. Let me tell you that this morning. I was an unrighteous man at one point in my life until the day I met Jesus in 1984. And I gave my life down at the church. And when I surrendered, God cleansed me. He saved me from my sins. Amen. He saved me. He cleansed me. He wrote my name in the Lamb's Book of Life. And I believe it this morning. And I'll tell you what, He'll do the same for you. And yes, yeah, you might have to lose some friends in the process, but that's okay. Because if you're a friend of the world, then you're not a friend of God. Amen. That's what the Bible says this morning. You can text me back. I'll show you the scripture. It's all right. Hey, I wouldn't say it if it wasn't God's word. Amen. And I began to think about that. Then and the things that go on. So this morning, this is your opportunity to make it right with the Lord. This is your opportunity, sinner friend. That's what they call me, sinner friend. I'm not defended by that. And I hope you're not either. I hope you're saying this pastor's got a lot of love this morning to tell me the truth. I want to tell you the truth. I'm not going to give you cake and ice cream and a party and let you be all up into that and then you forget about what the true meaning is. It's about going home one day. what is appointed unto man to die, and after that the judgment of Almighty God. I know that, and I'm glad I made my preparations. How about you this morning? Will you make your preparations with God? Will you say, Lord, forgive me? Lord, I realize I'm a sinner, undone, unrighteous, and I need you as my personal Savior. I want you to come into my life right now, and in Jesus' name, and amen. If you can say that this morning, just close your eyes and just ask God to say that prayer right now and ask the Lord to invite him into your home and say, I'm willing to live with you. I'm willing to live for you. I'm willing to live for you. I will not live a sinner's life no longer, but I'm going to live a Christian life. I'm going to live that life for you, Lord, because you did it all for me on the cross of Calvary. And Lord, we just thank you. Lord, as the ones that are bowing their head, the ones that are crying right now, and they're saying, I don't know what to say. All you got to say is this. Go ahead and repeat after me. Everybody just bow your head. And you need a Savior this morning. Just say, Father, Lord, I realize I'm a sinner. I'm lost and I'm undone. I'm righteous. I need you as my personal Savior. I need you, God. And I ask, Lord, you said, whosoever call upon you shall be saved. So this morning, I call upon you. And I ask you to forgive me, cleanse me, write my name in the Lamb's Book of Life, God. Please, write my name. And Lord, I'll serve you. I will serve you with all of my heart, with all of my soul, with all my might this morning. And when you say that, say amen. All right, I tell you, ain't God so good this morning? Amen. I'm gonna get us a song here. So you just bear with me, and we'll close out with that, and then I'm going to quit, okay? Well, we'll see what this is. He's worthy. Oh, well, that is not working. Oh, yeah, I'm having a little bit of problems with the, I think the audio has kind of went dead. I'm sorry about that. Maybe next week we can get a little bit better each time. I'm going to work on stuff and... give me some likes. Give me some prayer requests. If you want me to pray for your family, and a gentleman had his grandfather had pneumonia, and I've been praying for him, and I pray and hope that the results has turned out to be good, and through the Lord, because you call upon the name of the Lord, you shall be healed. Amen. I believe that in my heart this morning. If you want me to come out and preach the gospel at your church, feel free to give me a call. Or give me a text through Facebook and just say, hey, Brother Lovins, I'd like you to come preach the gospel at my church. Hey, and you never know, I might talk somebody into going, coming singing with me. Amen. And we just love to minister to the Lord. Amen. We're coming for the Lord anyways. Amen. When we come to have church. So I'm thankful for you all watching this morning. God bless y'all. Hope you really enjoyed Brother Sammy again. I since to exalt your brother highly than you, and I saw him very highly this morning. There's so many other worship services going to be on here just in a few minutes, and you just go ahead and enjoy the day. Be filled in the Spirit. May the Lord's face shine upon you. May His blessings overfill in your cup this morning. Amen. And that you will have more abundance than you've ever had before. And in Jesus' name. And the church said, amen. Love you guys to pieces. Pray for us. Maybe next Sunday I'll have it again. And again, I had mentioned at the beginning of this that we're going to have some interviews with singers. So you'll be praying for that God will open those doors and I get some singers to come. Amen. Maybe they'll sing a tune or two on a Saturday for us. Never know what's going to happen. But we're just thankful to have the opportunities this morning. Amen. All right. Love you guys. You take care. God bless.